Starbucks was founded by Jerry Baldwin, Gordon Bowker and Zee Seal, and opening its first store in 1971 at Washington. So the product consists of handcraft beverage, for example fresh brew coffee or an iced espresso beverage, iced coffee. And for merchandise, they have coffee and tea equipment, mugs, accessory, goods, books and gifts. And in Malaysia, Starbucks has outlet to 300 stores and employ more than 4,000 partners. There are 5 major ethical issues in the market level of Starbucks, for example, people, price, supply chain, management, environment and animal. For people, the firm had operation in China, Thailand, Philippines and Colombia that lives in the authoritarian regime for ethical consumer. And for the price, many people claim that the price are too high even though the world price of coffee had dropped. Next, for supply chain management, no appropriate child labor standard outside its program cafe for its supply chain. Next, for environment, it had the issue of emission of greenhouse gases and the coffee farming system. Lastly, for animals, Starbucks market farm animal product with the use of genetically modified animal feeds outside Malaysia. Starbucks has a few marketing practices, for example, consistent branding and customer experience. They have strong branding as the customer can know everywhere they see it. Next is the product is high quality, so that they can charge the high price to the customer. They also have the great place in order to give a wonderful place to the customer. Besides, they have a loyalty program, for example, free product, gift card and cashback offer. Lastly, for social media, they use all platforms, for example, Instagram, Facebook and Twitter to advertise their product. Next is analyzing marketing segment from Islamic perspective for Starbucks. The first segment is demography. So Starbucks only focus the people between 25 and 40 years old with high income, wealthier families and Generation Y. As for psychography, Starbucks only focus on upper middle class consumer and well-educated customer. And lastly, for geography, Starbucks only focus their business in cities as there are numerous number of high income customer. So in Islam, we are encouraged to spend our income according to our budget and recommended not to overspending. So that is why Starbucks only focus the wealthier and high income people. Next, analyzing marketing 4Ps from Islamic perspective. The first one is product. The product of Starbucks should be high quality and halal as it will affect our ibadah and health. For the price, Starbucks sell their coffee at a premium price because in Islam, you can charge a high price as long as it is high quality and excellent in condition. For promotion, Starbucks use wide range of platform, for example Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. As long as this platform doesn't support any action of LGBT or discrimination. Lastly, for the place, Starbucks has the great place in terms of cleanliness that is really important for Muslims. As for conclusion, Starbucks has an important lesson in success and a lot of motivation in the business world is required. In spite of the fact that Starbucks owned by non-Muslim, they had followed all the Islamic guidance in order to catch up the Muslim customer, especially in Malaysia. They emphasize halal product to the full so that the customer of the Muslim can consume without any mistrust. And they also emphasize the quality of cleanliness of the world that Muslim encourage in terms of food and drink.